On June 1st marked the official start of the 2011 Atlantic hurricane season. The St. Lucia Red Cross on that basis opened the season sensitizing members of the general public by way of a special march and distribution of disaster plan leaflets. The charitable organization is further bolstering its unit by implementing its strategic plan.
You need persons to understand what is the role of the International Red Cross, our mandate, our responsibilities. So we did a session on education, and then we went on to looking at the St. Lucia Red Cross, the International Red Cross, what are our strengths, what are our weaknesses, what are the things that we can do well, what are the things that may work against us, what are the things out there that we can work with to make sure that we meet the needs of the people of St. Lucia. And coming out of that, the information that we've gathered, we have a small team of volunteers who've come forward to continue the process of drafting the first document, and we will present this document to the General Assembly of the St. Lucia Red Cross.
Ms. O'Kalia says the St. Lucia Red Cross, as far as the hurricane season is concerned, never stopped preparing communities. The organization, in addition, is providing training through its community disaster response program.
We have 15 established community disaster response teams around the island. Yesterday's activity was one of the activities of the St. Lucia Red Cross as part of educating and preparing the community for this year's hurricane season. But we don't only focus on hurricanes, because that's not the only hazard that we would face at any time in St. Lucia.
The communications assistant says the process by which a strategic plan has been formulated is not only taking place in St. Lucia.
The International Red Cross has what we refer to as Strategy 2020, and Strategy 2020 is the strategic document of the International Red Cross, and it is what is that national societies themselves are to use to develop their own strategic plans. Within the Caribbean, just to ensure that the process gets going, within the Caribbean, they are a core group of what we call regional facilitators. And I'm one of those persons. So I support St. Lucia, Grenada, and Barbados national societies to develop their strategic plans.
Ms. O'Kalia says the process is very welcoming, and the document is expected by the end of July. For the DBS News World, Jason Holland-Seed reporting.